Hey, you guys, this is Mr. Sal. Go ahead and find the slope and y-intercept of number 1, and find the x and y-intercepts on number 2. It's just the bell work, all right? So get that done, and good luck. For the sub, by the way, if these guys give you any problems, please let me know. Take their names down, and I will make them pay when I return. Students, please be nice to the sub. They're doing the best that they can in my absence, and I greatly appreciate their help. So please be kind. And also, if I get any bad reports, just know that this last term, you're going to regret it, all right? I'm not going to tell you that you're going to regret it. So don't ask if you got a good or bad report. You will know. You will know. And at least in a couple weeks, if you got a bad report. All right, there's the answers for the bell work. So you guys are going to go ahead and correct the homework. This isn't something the sub needs to pass out. Notice the graphs are on the next slide, so keep that in mind. Correct this, please. You're going to score it today, but I'm going to take the scores next time. That's not a big deal, but you have to have your scores. We're not going to have time to correct this next time and then take scores. We're just going to take scores. All right, here is the second slide with the graph. Each graph is 3 points each. If you got it wrong, minus 3 points. All right. Hopefully you guys got all that scored. We'll take the scores next time again. Sub, this is the time right now to have the TAs pass out the classwork. There is only one classwork to pass out. It is the single yellow sheet. It says Properties of Reflections on it at the top. That is the title of it. There will be two homework assignments today. We did do most of this lesson, but we're going to go over just a little bit of what we went over and then expand on that too. So this is the second type of transformation we're going to talk about. It's a reflection. So it's kind of like taking something, or maybe like you, right? If you look in the mirror, we talked about this last time. It's like saying, well, I'm going to look in the mirror, which gives you a reflection, right? Well, see how that reflects like this? And then the line of reflection is where the mirror is. If we were to look away and actually have two of you looking across at each other reflected, this line right here would represent where the mirror is, okay? Now on the other hand, and we talked about this as well, some of you guys know who Bob Ross is, right? Well, Bob Ross used to paint these paintings, which was very nice, and one time I saw him do something like this in a mountain scene. And then what did he do to make it a reflection? Well, all he did is he kind of just drew a line straight across. And then if you look really far away, right, it kind of looks like, right, if this was Bob Ross, you'd have mountains, something like this. And maybe, I don't know, we can put a person on the top there. All right, and then it'd show the lines from the mountain like this, reflecting across the water. Well, I'm just showing for the trees specifically, but you can see how that works for either an up and down reflection or a left to right reflection. Now, of course, since this was Bob Ross, right, I mean, probably have to cover up most of this thing with some kind of tree. I don't know, you got to choose your own kind of tree, but I'm doing a palm tree. Because I can, and now I have a happy painting. All right, so describe the movement of a figure that has been reflected. Go ahead and take a moment to write that down on your paper. And we can see that these have been mirrored, all right? So the object has been flipped over specifically the y-axis right here. That makes the y-axis the line of reflection, which we'll go over that later on in this lesson. So that's the line of reflection. It will be important for you guys to understand with the line of reflection, by the way, that if we look at the pre-image point C right here, it is the same distance from the line of reflection as C prime. A is the same as well. We can see that it is 6 units away from the line of reflection, so is A prime. B and B prime work the same way. That will be important to remember as we go through this lesson, especially once we start moving the line of reflection away from the axis. All right, so go ahead and put the coordinate pairs in the table there if you haven't done that already. And there are the answers. This is something you should already know how to do. If you're struggling with that, then please get to MathLab so that we can get you the help you need. All right, let's go ahead and draw and label the image of the figure that's reflected over now the x-axis. So it may be helpful for you guys to draw that line of reflection right there. And there we have our line of reflection. That looks a little bit better. So since we're reflecting across this line, the distance from the old point to the new point has to be the same from the line of reflection there. So this would be A prime. C prime, C is 2 away, so C prime must also be 2 away. There's C prime. And B is 4 away, so B prime must also be 4 away, just in the opposite direction. And now we can draw the lines connecting those. And yes, this was B prime. And right here we have the coordinates in the table now. But what you need to do is write the coordinate rule to describe this reflection. So the coordinate rule, we have our pre-image x and y. This is going through a transformation where the x values, notice, did not change, and it shows that they did not change in the table. But what happened with the y's? We took the y values and we either multiplied them by negative 1 or we just made that a negative y. All right, so use questions 1 and 2 to explore some properties of reflections. Make at least 2 statements about the relationship between the line of reflection and the segments connecting the corresponding vertices of the image and pre-image of a reflection. So we kind of went over that already, but the segments connecting the point or the vertice with the line of reflection is the same distance away as the image point. So they're just the same distance away from the line of reflection. Also, all of the lines connecting those points are parallel to each other. That's not completely so important, but of course, once we start making other reflections, it will be kind of important. Knowing these helps us to determine what transformation has taken place based on the segments connecting the vertices. And we already went over this. Does it hold for problem number 2? Well, again, we can look at these and connect the points with lines. And we can see right here, if I had drawn my line straight, they are all parallel. and they are all the same distance away from the line of reflection. For a translation, we learned that corresponding segments are parallel. That's just talking about the segments of the lines. So A prime, B prime would be parallel to AB. But is that true for reflections? Now, for them to be parallel, they do have to have the same slope. But right here, we can see that the slopes are not the same. In fact, one's positive and one's negative. The lines CB and C prime, B prime, they are parallel because the slopes are exactly the same, but for reflections, it won't always come out that way. So go and take a moment and find the slopes of these line segments. And there you have it. Maybe some of you guys made stair steps like this. So A prime to C prime is negative 1. And went down 1 and to the right 5. And from B prime to C prime, you went to the right 3. And then up 2, so that'd be 2/3. And from A prime to B prime, you went down 3. And then to the right 2. So that'd be a negative 3/2. Now that's just for the primes. You do the same thing on this other triangle. Again, by the time we end up doing that with the stair steps, you can see that it kind of closes the shape into a rectangle. But an interesting thing about the slopes there, right, is what do you see about the slopes and how does that connect to the coordinate rule, which we have right here? Well, hopefully you guys understand that. See how the Y changed from a positive to a negative? Same with the originals. The original went from a positive to a negative. If it was negative, then it became a positive. So now let's look at corresponding segments, for example, BC and B' C'. What do we notice about the lengths? Well, that length right there is 7 for BC. B' C' has the same length. So we can see now that through reflections, that lengths are preserved. So in other words, the lengths don't change if we reflect an image. A pre-image, rather. All right, let's go ahead and reflect this quadrilateral ABCD across the line y equals negative 1. And to do that, let's go ahead and draw ourselves a line of reflection where y equals negative 1, and that is going to be right here. That's where y is negative 1, and so our line is going to be right here. Let's go ahead and look now at the distances each point is from the line of reflection. D is 2 away, so D prime will have to be 2 away in the opposite direction. So this is where D prime is. A is 6 units away from the line of reflection, so we'll have to go 6 away from the line of reflection to get A prime. And B prime also is 6 units away right here. So 6 units in this direction puts us right here at where y is -7. C is 2 units away, so C prime will be 2 units away right here. And I'll label this one B prime. All we have to do now that we have those points is to connect the dots. And there we have it. Now you can make it a little bit more profound if you want. Now what you're going to need to do is find the points for the pre-image and the image. So hopefully you're able to draw those in, and there they are, each of those ordered pairs for the pre-image and the image. So now what we need is a coordinate rule to describe this reflection. Go ahead and take a few minutes here and see if you can figure out what that is. So to do this, we've got to look at the coordinates of the pre-image. So I'm going to look at C, right? C is 8, 1. And C prime is 8 and -3. So we didn't do anything to the X's, by the way. So on the rule, we know that at least that much. The X's haven't changed at all. But remember, when we reflect over the x-axis, what did we do with the y? Well, we made it a negative, didn't we? So we can take the negative value y. And where would that put us? Well, with C, if we reflected over the x-axis, it would have put us right there. But then we've got to go down 2 more. So we take that negative value of y and we subtract 2, and that right there is how we found and can find the coordinates for all the other points. Let's just check using point A, right? So A is 2, 5, and A prime is 2, -7. Well, if I apply this rule, then I have X, which is 2, and I take the negative value of my y, which would then be -5, and then I subtract 2. Does that give me -7? Yes, it does. There's our rule. Bam. All right, let's reflect this triangle ABC across the line x equals negative 5. Go ahead and take a moment to try that out. All right, and there we have it. We have that purple line, which is the line of reflection. And, of course, hopefully we can see that the distance each of these are away from the line of reflection is the same. Okay, just in the opposite direction again. Something like this, right? And C, for example, looks like that was 8 away from the line of reflection. So C prime is 8 in the other direction right here. All right, and this is the point where we get to that we're not really concerned with the lines connecting the points. All we're concerned with any type of transformation, really, are the points, okay? So if you can just focus on the points, I'm going to highlight those. We have B here, A there, and C there. If you can just focus on the points, this will make a lot of sense because right now, a lot of you guys are looking at this with the line of reflection being the y-axis, which is this purple line, and then you're just not sure what to do, right? Because it overlaps the line of reflection. Again, focus on the points and use the rules you've learned in this lesson and on the worksheets. Just apply them to the points, not the lines crossing over the line of reflection. All right, so let's take the shape. Again, since we're focusing on the points, how far away is C, for example? I'm going to start with C. How far away is that from the line of reflection? It's 3 units. So So I need to go 3 units in the other direction, which would then give me C prime. A works the same way. It's 3 units away. So I go 3 units in the opposite direction, and that gives me this point, A prime. B is on the line of reflection. So how far away is it? 0. That means that B prime is going to be in the exact same point. They are the same distance away, 0, from that line of reflection. All I got to do now is connect these points with my line. And hopefully your lines are straighter than mine. I don't know. Maybe the drawing would help. There we go. That's a better drawing with straighter lines. And again, you can see the distance away from the line of reflection is just for the points. Okay? We're not concerned about the lines, because sometimes we don't draw them very straight, right? Well, what about this? We're going to reflect this over the line y equals x. See if you can do that. So when we look at these, we're really looking at the distance those points are away from the line of reflection. So the distance is really the perpendicular line that connects, for example, B with this line of reflection. Well, how do we make that perpendicular? Perpendicular lines have an opposite reciprocal slope, and the slope of this line of reflection is 1. So the lines connecting all of these points to the line of reflection will be the opposite, negative 1, and if we reciprocate that, you'd have negative 1 over 1. So in other words, I'm going to stair-step this down using that slope until I come to that point. And how many steps do I have? Well, right here, I can see that I went up 1. I'll use a different color. 1, 2, 3, 4 steps. So I'm going to continue those steps, 4 steps, and that will give me my new point, B prime. 1, 2, 3, 4 steps. And that gives me my B prime. So again, we're looking for the perpendicular line to the line of reflection. You'll see it worked with all the other examples that we've done as well. Except for it was straight across, not with some slope. So we have this C. Again, I'm going down 1 to the right 1 from the slope of the perpendicular line. Perpendicular, we can write it like this, perpendicular slope. So I go down 1 to the right 1, down 1 to the right, down 1 to the right. And how many steps is that to get to this point? 1, 2, 3, 4 steps. So I'll continue that 1, 2, 3, 4 steps. And that right there is my C prime. We can see that the lengths are the same. Finally, let's look at A. Down 1 to the right, down 1 to the right. And I have my distance now. It is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 steps. So I will continue that. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. And that's my new point, A prime. And I can draw the triangle now. Hopefully yours is a better drawing than mine. Again, noticing that the distance are the same from the point on the pre-image to the image, we have to know that that is a perpendicular distance, or a perpendicular line, I should say. Now we'll go ahead and write the coordinates in for each of those two triangles. And hopefully that's what you got. But now see if you can write the coordinate rule. Again, I highly suggest that we focus on one of the three points and of the pre-image and then the image as well. See if you can figure out what that is. Well, I'm going to focus on A. And A prime right here, okay? Notice that the X became, I should say, the Y became the X, and the X became the Y, right? Well, how does that look? So if I take my pre-image and I transform that across a reflection of the line Y equals X, then what did I do? I just swapped my X and my Y like this. That is what the coordinate rule would look like. And will this coordinate rule hold for any figure reflected over the line y equals x? Yes, it will, and it has to do with the slope, right? It is the opposite reciprocal. On these ones, notice we're just reciprocating those values. All right, now go ahead and find the slopes of the corresponding segments. So hopefully you got these slopes. And what do you notice about these slopes? Well, hopefully you see that they just kind of reciprocated, right? They didn't change from to their opposite values. They just reciprocated. So what is the coordinate rule for a figure reflected across the line y equals negative x? And that would look something like this. Okay, so we're looking at that purple line. If we reflected across that line, what do you think the coordinate rule would be? Well, now we would be looking at something where, since the x is negative, we're still going to flip these two, right? The x's and the y's from the pre-image to the image. But the difference now is that we're going to make those negatives, which is shown in the line, the line of reflection there. The following table lists the properties of translations discovered in the previous lesson. Put a check mark in the box if the property is also true for reflections. Add additional statements to the table that are only true for reflections. All right, so you should have check marks next to these. Also true for reflections, go ahead and take a look at these ones and see if that's true. And yes, all of these are true. So to find the line of reflection, all right, so let's go ahead and take a look at these. We need to look at the point on a pre-image and connect it to the point of the image. And if we look at the distance between these two, we can see that, for example, this one is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 units away from each other. The line of reflection just splits that in half, so it has to be through this point. But we do need to connect two other points. Let's choose M and M prime. And if we connect these, they are, looks like they're 16 units away. So if we cut that in half, it would be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. And that gives us the midpoint of the line that connects those two. Well, to find the line of reflection, all we've got to do is connect the points that we just created right there. And that would be a small red line, not that one, but this line right here, which now we can extend so that it becomes a line of reflection. And there we go. That's the line of reflection, but what is the equation for it? Well, that's where x is negative 2 right here. So the equation is just x equals negative 2. So the next thing you should do is write the coordinate rule for the line of reflection. I've kind of gone over that already. This is kind of like reflecting over the y-axis. All right, let's look at the coordinate rule for the line of reflection. We would have the equation. We have our pre-image point. Let's use K on this one. So K, we can see, is 6 units away from the y-axis. And the reason why we look at that is because this line of reflection, x equals negative 2, is kind of like the y-axis, but it's been moved to the left 2 places, right? So if I reflected k across the y-axis, that would have put k right here, right? But then what did we do? Then, after that, we moved it to the left. I should put that left 4 spaces, right? After we reflected this across the line y equals 0, or the y-axis. So our coordinate rule, we have xy. We're transforming this. We're not doing anything to the y values. They're staying the same. But the rule for reflecting across the y-axis was negative x. But then after that, we still did something. We moved it to the left 4 spaces, which is more of a translation, and that's why it shows up that way. So this is the rule for this reflection. All right, go and take a moment and draw the line of reflection for this graph. And there it is. Hopefully you guys connected any two of the corresponding points and then found the halfway point and connected those two points. What's the equation for the line of reflection? Well, this one is where y is 4, so that's just that line of reflection there. The coordinate rule, though, we need to consider. This line is very much like the line of reflection being the x-axis. So the coordinate rule for that one was where we take the x's don't change, but the y's we do change. We would make that a negative y, right? So how would that look if I looked at x and I reflected it across the x-axis? It would put me down here at where y is negative 3. But then I have to move it up. How many spaces? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So I have to add 8 to that. And we can see this would work the same for w, right? If I move w across the y-axis and made that y value positive, I'd be where y is 1. But then I have to move it up 8 spaces to get to where w prime is. Y prime works exactly the same way. All right, take a moment and see if you can write the equation for this line of reflection. All right, let's take a moment and look at why it is y equals 2x plus 8. Well, this is in slope-intercept form, so first we need to find the slope, meaning we just need to look at any two points on this line. It goes up to, and then to the right, 1. So the slope would be 2 over 1. And the y-intercept is this point right here, which would have been 0, 8. And we can see that it goes through that point on the line. Otherwise, we have to use point slope form, which we can do, and you can watch other videos on Canvas on how to do that from previous units. And knowing that, that's why we have y equals the slope 2 times the x plus the y-intercept was 0, 8. All right, and that'll do it. Go ahead and have the sub pass out the homework. There should be 2 homework sheets. Both of them are an orangish type color. The TAs can do that. If you guys need to watch this again, I'm going to have it on Canvas. If you have other questions, get to Math Lab, please, next Tuesday, and we can get you the help you need.